Hi, FlossTube. My name is Charisse Raven, otherwise known as Denkai. This is my sixth, maybe seventh. Oh, I don't care. Who cares? Who cares? Who's counting? FlossTube update. FlossTube update. Yes, we're gonna go and we're gonna look at. What day is it today? March. We're gonna look at what I've stitched end of February, beginning of March, and then we'll look at plans for April. A little bit of haul, not a lot. Some exciting giveaways. Yay! I'm trying to think. And then obviously an amazing joke at the end. So that's what we're doing today. Right, first I will update you with general life stuff in case you're interested. If you're not, then just scroll forward and we'll pretend that you cared. Right, okay. But my month's been okay. Just kind of same old, really. Nothing, too interesting or fun happening. Oh, you have to excuse me. I'm a bit spotty because I literally have no makeup on because I didn't go to work today. I was on holiday today, day's leave. So yeah, when I'm on holiday, I'm like, I can't be bothered with makeup. So you got me fresh face. Yeah, so I'll stop rambling. Right, in stitchy related news for this month, in my sewing crafty class, I made my anti-pat knitting bag. These are the pictures, Mike, if you could put them in now. Some lovely little knitting. I just got the I think I watched a video online. Like a Debbie Shaw knitting bag kind of thing, because she knits, and she bought me the sewing machine, so I thought, oh, better make her something nice. So yeah, did that. Eden, I needed to make him a bag. Some of you know, he has autism, and he's kind of really struggling with his emotions at the minute. He's getting really frustrated and angry, and kind of not knowing how to deal with it, or just even recognize those emotions, because obviously with autism, people with autism sometimes struggle with recognizing emotion and then expressing it appropriately, really. So yeah, we made him a little pack so he can kind of go through and like, how do you feel? And this is how you're kind of feeling and what to do about it. And no, you don't hit people. No, don't throw that. And then just like a list of like other ways that he can kind of chill out and calm himself down. So we made him like a little pack. And I needed to stitch a little bag, and he loves numbers, so stitched him a little number bag. Well, I didn't stitch it, I sewed it on sewing machine. And there's a picture of this, or that. Is it that? Or this? Anyway, here it is. Bing! I love the little bings. If you could put a picture up, Mike, thank you very much. So that's my kind of life and crafty related news. I'm trying to think what else there is. Nope, that's that. Showing my two things that I made. I did make something else, but I'll show you that later. Right, whips. We'll start with fantasy. My fantasy cell. Have to make this one a proper project bag. It's still got its little my little tuff bag. Get this out of the hoop, and you can see what we're doing for this. Put it on a little board for you. Random threads. Here we go. This is creased bugger. Seriously, creased. I should really iron. Well, I'll iron it at the end, maybe. Well, I think I'll have to. Ah, losing it. Where are we? There we go. Now we're finally sorted. That is the Phoenix, and that was this month's release for the Lakeside Fantasy. I've just kept to the normal colours and things. I haven't done the back stitching yet, which is why it looks very different to the other one. I generally, if you can see from that one there, that one's complete, and so is that one. I like to losing my hoop. I like to do complete backstitch, so I know on the pattern, Doreen Jones has kind of done a little bit of backstitch and then little knot kind of thing. I would generally kind of just go all around it. Not that I like backstitching, I don't mind it, it's all right. But I think it just kind of makes it pop. Pow! There you go. So that is my little phoenix. Isn't she cute? She's adorable. I love it. I don't name her. I know some people name the charts and stuff. I think that's real cute, but I don't really have a name. I don't know. Forks. There we go. I bet everyone else thought the same thing, didn't you? Didn't you? If you stitch it, I bet yours is called Forks as well. Awesome name. I salute you. Yes. There's Forks. This is just on 14 karat Ada. Little needle minder, because I sell needle minders. That's what I'm buying. I have changed some of the colours. I've gone kind of for like a green. Some of my, I think the colour around there and the swirly bits. A lot of the colours are quite different. If you want to know what colours I've used or the changes that I've made, you'll have to go through other videos because I didn't write it down and can't be asked looking it up now. But I have gone through them as I've done them in previous videos. Right, pack this one away. That is the Lakeside. Much impressed with myself. I'm up to date, reasonably up to date. The next one hasn't come out, so I still have time to do the back stitching. So there's still hope. Still hope. Although saying that, I've still got months left to do, but I've nearly done Marches. Yay! Right, next, Under the Sea. That is in a funky little dog bag. Like, no idea what that fluff was that came off there. Okay, what am I doing? About that, my Under the Sea one. Take it off the hoop. I'm a bit of a hooper, and we will put this on the board. This is stitched on 28 count even weave, hand-dyed by Chromatic Alchemy, and it's called, I know the name, Poseidon. Is it Poseidon? I think it's Poseidon. I think I kept, they give you a little piece of paper, I think I kept the little piece of paper because I didn't want to forget. Ha ha! Okay. It is Poseidon, it is 28 count. It's Brittany Lagana. Never mind, I was nearly there. It's a linen. Although technically linen is an even weave, but anyway, let's not get pedantic. Right, here we go. As you can see, last month is there. Kind of finished off last month, although I haven't finished all of the back stitching. Let me just straighten that up a little bit for you. There we go. Yeah, I started on this month, which is there, and I have like two fish done, but they're so cute. I'm gonna do the last little fish there, which would be above there, and then obviously kind of continuing on the little seaweed thing. A little turtle. Yes, and Kate from Lakeside accidentally emailed out the April one, the little submarine, 2 weeks too early, but never mind, we don't care, we like him. And that's got some gorgeous colours in. I'm really liking that, and I wouldn't have thought. I was really surprised that it was a submarine. I'm like, that is just awesome, because obviously they're under the sea, you know, why wouldn't you? So, but yeah, I was like, that's really good, I really like that, I approve. So yeah, gonna put that on the end. I have 6 weeks now. Although, do you ever think, oh, I've got 6 weeks to do it. 6 weeks, you know, and get it done. I'll probably come to like next month's video and I'll be like, ah, I've not done it. Anyway, so yeah, I don't know whether I should do the back stitching first, like finish off the back stitching. Let me roll that up. For February's first. Big hoop mark right in the middle of it. I'm actually quite proud of that stitching. It's nice. Do I backstitch and then move on? I might backstitch and then move on to the next month, because otherwise I'll have like February, Marches and Aprils all unbackstitched, and then I have to go and do it all, which I don't mind, but it's not as nice as cross stitching, I think. Maybe, although that said, I am enjoying my next whip, which has a lot of like backstitching. That's a nice little segue, isn't it? You know, bordering from backstitch from one to backstitch from another. You know, segue skills like that. I should be a presenter. I should so be a TV presenter. Right. The next whip, all the backstitch talk, is obviously the Stitchrovia yarn. The sal that I wasn't going to do because I already have too much stuff, but the sal that I really like, so I'm doing it anyway. That's the one. If you don't know about this one, it's for Mind, so it's for charity. So that gets another I approve. I need like a little jingle or a little, I don't know, stamp. I approve. You get the board so you can see what I've done. This is a beast. Although saying that, it looks like I've just stitched loads of, I've got loads of blue fabric at the end of this. Obviously I didn't cut that right. Like trails of it. What's going on there? Right. This is the last time you saw it. It looked like this. Right, this is the Stitchrovia sal where I'm up to. As you can see, you bring that up. I've done the quotes. I was gonna go for purple outside and then green for the word quote. But I saw it and I thought, they might look a bit nicer reversed, I think. So anyway, I'm reversing them. So we're having purple as written quotes to live by. And God, I'm having real trouble keeping hold of anything tonight, aren't I? Quotes to live by. And then I'm gonna do to, oh, what is wrong with me? It's like my fingers won't work. Quotes to live by. So the quotes is in purple, and then the background will be in turquoise. Obviously, you've got this is January's part. February's part has been released. That goes there. And then Marches is there. I'm quite behind on this one, but I only do it when I get chance and I'm downstairs and got, you know, a quick 10 minutes or whatever while something's cooking or while I'm just watching Eden for summer. And I'll just whip out my whip. Sounds kinky, sorry. Yeah, so yeah. So I just whip it out. And then just do the stitching. I have, if you look at the border, you can kind of see the little line that's gone around. That's like the preliminary border. Not even like the proper border, the like the faux border, like a mini border. I like the word border. That is in Grape Ice by Weeks Dyeworks. And I really liked that. You can kind of see it's variegated, or maybe you can't see. I'll try and get a bit closer up. You can see a lot better on my Instagram. If you want to join me on Instagram, this is my name, Denkai underscore 55. Remembered, I didn't even have to look. But yeah, you can kind of see light pinky to like dark purpley to back to pinky. I think it looks really nice. And I think when it's finished, I'll try and kind of bring out the colour in the border by substituting maybe a couple of colours in the actual chart itself with like some of the pinks and some of the purples. It'll all go. It'll look fabulous. Lovely. Anyway, it's all about sayings. So I have my sayings needle minder, and it says, I don't expect everything handed to me. Just set it down wherever. And I love that. That's like me. Mike! What a brew. Oh, Mike. I refer to him. I don't think I'm only telling me this. We had this thing when we first started going out and stuff that he'd like put my socks on, or he'd like find I'd get like cold feet. And I'm like, my feet are cold. So he'd go and get socks for me, and like big fluffy socks, and put my socks on for me. So I referred to him, and I still do, refer to him as my sock bitch. So whenever I need socks, oh no, it's slippers. He does slippers as well now. So like big ones, you can't go on like the little Ugg boot things. My Mike, I need sock bitch. So he kind of comes and he acts as a sock bitch and gets me socks and puts them on. So yeah, that's very apt, isn't it? Just sit it down wherever. I sound real spoiled. I am real spoiled. Who are we kidding? Right, fantasy. Under the sea. Citrovia. What else? Done that one, done that one, done that one. Just found a black bra in my whip drawer pile. Do you ever do that? Like you stitch in, you just, oh, that's really annoying, and just whip it off. Shove it in there. I'll check it out. There's probably like five bras at the bottom of that thing. Right. This is my Haid. I was taking part in the Haid challenge, which was to kind of finish a page by the 7th of April. 7th of April. And I'm really sad about this one. Really sad. Because this is like the closest I've ever come to like finishing a page, and I'm not even halfway. But I don't know, I just don't have time. Let me have a look, and I will show you what I mean. I'll put it in here. I should really show you what I'm doing first, shouldn't I? That would be helpful. Where's my sheet? Where's my sheet? Where's my flower? Here we go. I did a little printout to show you. Excuse me. HEI. There we go. This is the Wannabe Mermaid with no nipples, otherwise known as Into the Sea. It's Heaven and Earth design, and it's designed by Jeremy Kettner. And I love her. I think she's very beautiful. She's going to my bathroom in about 20 years when I finish. I'm not kidding. It will take that long. Anyway, the Haid challenge was to finish a page. I'm sorry to say, I've done nearly half a page. This is where it was before. Mike, if you would. That is how it looked before. This is how it looks now. I have done some. You can see, finished off that square. Did some of that balloon, and the page is actually like down there, so I don't think it's that. Yeah, I'm about maybe a third done. I don't think, sorry, itchy nose. I don't think I'm gonna get it done really, which I'm really sad about. But you can see where it is. It's like that top corner there. Yay. So I'm quite pleased with it. It's nice blues. But yeah, it's sad. That's like my third Hay challenge that I signed up for that I haven't done. They should have a page a year. That is something I can get behind. That's something that I can do. I've just been super busy. Super busy. But I've tried to do it. And I will say, I have prioritised the Haid. I did think at the beginning of the month, yes, I can still do this. I can still make it. It's the 7th, you know. I've still got time. Sad. But no, I haven't. Which is a shame, actually. I would like to do it. I just seem to take so long to do Haids. But never mind. It's the process, isn't it, really? Am I kidding? It's the final result. It's both. It is both. I'm a both kind of person. It is both. I do like stitching. It's just nice creating it, isn't it? I like that. So, yes, I did prioritise the Haid at the expense of my Mania 17 start. You're going to laugh when you see this. That was the chair. That was the chair. I've got a squeaky chair. Where is it? Where's my even room? Sorry, 1 second. This just shows how much of this I've done that the whip's like right at the bottom of the pile. So, on the 17th, I did my Mania 17 start. It was, let me get it out. There we go. It was Raven Moon, or Raven's Moon. This is a Gecko Rouge chart, even. And it's not so much a chart, it's more a kit. And it kind of comes with all the, you know, everything there. All your threads and floss and fabric and everything. And you can say what count you want it in. I have 18 count Ada, because that's how I like to do my big charts in 18 count Ada. So yeah, Raven's Moon. This is what I have done. This is like guilty face. That is it. I don't mind, but it's like all one colour. And it's because it was all dark. The coverage isn't that bad. The coverage is quite nice. Oh, but don't mind showing you that. It's that, obviously, like, nearly 400 stitches, that's all. I don't mind the fact that it's dark. That's not a problem. I think that there's a... It's a start, isn't it? Stitch Mania 17 start, obviously, is to start a new piece on the 17th of every month. That was it. That is still a start. Technically, if you want to get technical, that is a start. So I'm still counting it as a start. And I love this chart. I absolutely love it. I think she's beautiful. The artwork is by Sandra... No, it's not. Who's it by? Oh my God, completely gone. Sandra someone. Sandra Vargas. That's it. And of course it says it at the top. Sandra Vargas. I think it's gorgeous. But she sells like notepads and everything else. And other things, which I will come to in a minute. But yeah. Isn't it the case though, sometimes you love the picture, but then you try and stitch it and you don't feel the same about it. Well, it's not that I don't feel the same, it's just that I was prioritising to try and get that bloody page done for the Haid and obviously failing miserably. But there we go. There we go. But still, it's a start. I'm going to take off the hoop actually so I don't mess it up too much. It's a start. And I will stitch it in the future, so it's not like it's wasted. I will definitely do it. I do love it. I do love the picture. So I am pleased that that was my start. Obviously, that's not, you know, much to show you guys, but there we go. You know, we stitch for ourselves, don't we? We stitch for the things that we love and the people that we love, and that's what it's all about. And I like it. Anyway, let me pack that away. If I may. There we go. Right. Speaking of Stitch Mania, this is my next one. Oh, go over plans. My plans for April. God, can you believe it's April already? Well, no, it's not as much. But still, it's March and then it's April. It's just, the year is just so fast. Anyway, My plans for end of March, beginning of April will be to finish off the back stitching for the fantasy cell for the Phoenix Forks, my little Phoenix, and then obviously do the next months. I'm still going for dragon. There's got to be a dragon in there somewhere. Obviously, this month's prediction of Forks the Phoenix was wrong, but never mind. You can't win them all. I got mermaid, you know. Psychic ball, a bit foggy there, but we're going to go for dragon. Next time, it's a dragon. And under the sea, I'm going to do the submarine. I'm not going to guess that one because we know it's a submarine. So yeah, I will do that. And I will try and chip a bit more off the Stitcherovia. I am really enjoying that one. I do like it. Although, no, I don't like backstitch. It's all right. But I'm really enjoying, I don't know, making the words. It's a bit strange. Like, I really enjoy, like, outlining all of the words and doing, like, the borders. I don't know. I think it's a lot easier than backstitching on a chart that's already completed and you're having to find the right hole. If there's nothing already there to stitch over, it's a lot easier. I hope that makes sense. Yes, so I'm going to do the Stitcherovia one. The Hayd, I don't know. I don't think I can get a page done in like 3 weeks. I don't know. Maybe if I seriously bust some balls, I might be able to. I don't know. My Raven Moon is going to go into the whips pile to be drawn out late. Not UFO. Yeah, I'm going to UFO-er. I know. Oh, I really like it. That was a proper little moan, wasn't it? I really like it. We'll leave her in the whips pile. She'll probably, you know, slowly make her way to the bottom, but I will do her eventually because I do love her. Do love that picture. It's lovely. Right. My mania start for tonight, incidentally, because it is the 17th, is let me get this out. Not that one because that's the chart. It's out of a magazine, so just bear with me for 1 second. I'm gonna have to just grab two a couple of these to put up just so it can stick on so I can show you properly. Beep. You stay there. You stay there. Right. This I can overlay it properly. I'm sorry about this. I should maybe thought about it a bit sooner and got it all put out, but tough. Never mind. You have to bear with. Bear with. Bear with. If you come from England and you know what I'm going on about, then you'll think I'm funny. If not, then you won't. It's a TV show. Excuse me. Can humans catch kennel cough? This is a really silly question. My mum's dog's got kennel cough, and ever since she came. One second, excuse me. Ever since she came round today, I've been coughing loads. I'm thinking, have I got kennel cough? Not that I have ever got it. Not that I'm like a dog. But do you know what I mean? I don't know. I don't know what I'm talking about. Anyway, stop rambling. This is from, I'll show you my chart. This is my mania start. It is a little baby sampler. Let me just put that. Little baby sampler. That is from Cross Stitch Crazy from issue 219, which is from September 2016. So yeah, there we go. That is what I will be stitching this month or April as my Stitch Mania 17 start. Some of you know that I talked about in my last video when I got my haul. Oh, I'll be doing it on 16 count Ada. Is that 16 count? Maybe 18. 18 or 16 count, but I've chosen Ada anyway. I find Ada easier to stitch on, but then when I get going on even weave, I find that easier. I don't know if that makes sense. It's like even weave, I prefer it if I can kind of, if it's easier, the chart's easier to follow, because I find counting over two is a lot easier to kind of lose my hole, as it were. whereas Ada, it's a lot easier not to. Am I making sense? I don't know if I'm making sense. It's Friday night, you know. Head's like blown. It's like... Anyway, I have floss here. And that's because on here, there are some seriously funky colours. I love the turquoises. I love the purples. The oranges. I do like oranges. And I like the colours. But I think for a baby sampler, it's a bit too bright. I don't know if that's like the traditionalism person in me, traditionalist in me. So I've had some pastels. So yeah, I'm gonna, instead of some of like the very vibrant, I don't know if you can see the vibracity, is that a word? That's an awesome word, especially if I just made it up. As you can see, the vibracity of the colours. But I think for a baby sampler, little girl might put some, you know, some pastels in there. So I've got the original colours, and then I was like, what the hell? I'll get a couple of pastels. So I'm going to have fun tonight, kind of looking at the colours and how I want to change them. Like, yay, floss! So yeah, I'll be doing that. And then we'll start. She's having the baby on the 1st of May. My sister. It's my sister's baby. And I will be Auntie Cherise. Auntie Sheza. And yeah, it's her first. First time auntie. Yay! And I thought, I've got to do a sampler. It's like a must. You know, new baby, sampler! Especially if you cross stitch it or needle pointer, sampler, get your sampler out. So yeah, she's called Eleanor, and she knows it's a girl. And I'm birthing partner. And if you know my sister, she doesn't watch this, so I can say this without any repercussions. She's a moody cow. My sister is seriously moody. Like even normal Laura is moody. I seem to have like. I'm an even keel on my moods, whereas hers like. I feel so sorry for a boyfriend. He's like the patience of a saint, or he seriously needs patience of the saint with Laura. And pregnant Laura is just going to be horrendous when she has this baby. But never mind, it will be worth it in the end, I'm sure. So yeah, I've got a little baby sampler for little baby Eleanor, and we'll see how that goes. Obviously, typical Cherise, leaving everything until last minute because it's March 17th, and then it's like 6 weeks, is it? End of March, end of April, oh god, 6 weeks. I can do it. I can so do that. We'll see. We will see. But that is what I'm doing. Yay! So I'm liking that. Let me just put the floss back in this bag. Keep it all together. There we go. And we will see how that's coming on next week. Next week? Next update. Right, where else? Where are we? Haul. I have a little box. Whenever I get haul, it goes in the box until my video. Like, how awesome is that? I'm like organised. Kind of. I did want to show you this. It's technically not cross stitch related, but I love it and I'm showing you it. It's kind of crafty. It's a little squiddy. How adorable is that? One of my friends made it on Etsy. I ordered from a shop and she sent me that as like a little gift because she's lovely. And I was like, oh, squiddy. So, Squiddy is in the craft room, at home with the craft. Right, haul. There is a couple of bits of haul to show you. The first is a chart, and I'm going to have to kind of go back a bit so you can see the picture, but you can't see the chart, if that makes sense. So, that... It's the first time you see the picture. Never mind. What I will do is I will link it from their website. My chairs. doing dodgy stuff. It is ABC de la Produce. Producier. It's French. From Jardin Privé. I will link the website. And it's part of their salle. It's their ABC style. You can get it in French or in English. I've got the English version because I'm English. I could have been fancy and done the French one, but I thought, no, because then no one will understand. So yeah, I've gone for the English one. This was enabled from Kate Worthington from Lakeside. I saw hers and I was just like, oh, you know, when you see people's charts and stuff and there's so many sales, there needs to be a website that's like dedicated to sales, really, isn't there? Like all the sales that are going on, or if there's any kind of coming up. Because I really love this. It's like, obviously you can see from the picture. We'll try and put a picture in here. Mike, bling! I really love it. I love the fact that it's like ABC. And it is just, it's like quite thin, but quite long. So it'd be nice as like a wall hanging kind of thing. Yeah, and I saw it. I'm not doing it as part of the sale, but I am going to collect all of the pieces and yeah, sew them all together. I love it. I love it. You ever see some pictures or some charts and you're just like, that is just, I love it. So that's that. The second bit of haul, I only have two bits of haul this month. The second bit of haul, although technically it is haul, but technically it's not haul because I made it. But I made it for me. So I'm counting it. It is, if you recall, I said about the Raven Moon, where the Sandra Vargas graphics or stickers. dropped it. This is a little needle minder that I made. That's one. I made three. That's two. I thought I might put that on the Lakeside. And this one. There's three. And I got the stickers and I made them into needle minders. Because that's what I do. I make needle minders. And I sell needle minders. And yeah, I made this one. And I was real chuffed with myself. I do have videos out as well. If you want to know how to make needle minders yourself, there'll be links in. And they're on my YouTube channel. And you can have a look and have a go yourself at making them. But yeah, I just got Sandra Vargas. I shouldn't really say that or endorse that, should I? Considering, I don't know if she sells them. Does she sell them? I don't know if she sells them herself. I don't think she sells them herself. Well, there's not on her website. Anyway, but yeah, so, and I thought, I like that and I want to do something for me. And I've done that for me. So now I can take it out of the whole box and add it to the chart. So yeah, that's that. That's a pretty pathetic haul month. I'm going to have to do better next month, aren't I? I'm going to have to go out and buy myself something. yes, I will. And April is birthday. And I do believe that on my mania start for May is Mirabilia. So I am planning on doing a how to get up a Mirabilia video to help people and as an excuse to buy things. So that will be the next one. Right. Last, done that hauls is giveaways. And I'm just going to pause the video while I shout my husband because I like him to kind of draw things because I don't want to, you know, it comes up and it's like, ah, she's drawn you again for the fifth time. Anyway. I'm back. Just waiting for Mike. He's coming up. Excuse me. Yeah. So we're waiting for Mike. And then we're going to do drawing for giveaways. So. One thing I did have down that I wanted to say is. Not apologise. Because I'm not going to apologise. But. Well, I am kind of. I am behind. With. Flosstube. I am sorry. But. I have an addiction. It's only started off slight with like, you know, one or two kind of videos, Marvel videos, And now suddenly I'm watching the entire Marvel history from beginning. So we've had like Iron Man 1, Iron Man 2. I think we've had Captain America. Obviously Captain America was the first. This is in chronological order, not of date of release, but in date of occurrence. So I'm kind of halfway through now. And I think I'm just in the middle of Captain America Winter Soldier. I think I've still got Civil War and I think a couple of others. It's awesome. But it's keeping me very busy. And I'm like, you know, I do want to watch Flush Tube, but I love my superheroes. I love Marvel. So yeah, I'm doing that. But once that's finished, I'm straight back on Flush Tube. So don't feel too neglected. You know, I will get around to it. Oh my God. Can you hear him?
Yeah, I'm on too early.
No, come on. There you go. Can you see him?
I'm Mike.
This is Mike, my husband. Pull your chair up, darling. You have to get in.
I've just been out of bingo hall.
No, you have not. Normally, I was winding him up because normally I say this is my not so glamorous assistant. Obviously tonight.
But tonight.
You are my glamorous assistant.
Yes.
You look spiffing.
Thank you.
We're British, so you look spiffing. Don't you agree?
Jolly
good.
Yes, all spiffing. That. Everything alright?
Yeah. Yep. Good.
Good.
Right. Giveaway. In my last guide to when I made, can't speak.
Is this your plan to get rid of me?
No. What do you mean?
You just say you brought me in, and then you said it's a giveaway.
No. In my last video, I did a bit of a guide on how to make bottle top needle minders. If you just reach behind you and get the needle minders on the board, you might have to turn around.
Okay.
We made some needle minders together.
Ta-da!
I've stuck them on my magnetic board. I love these boards, they're awesome. So, those are the ones that we made together. They're really cute. It was obviously Valentine's Day. You've got the rhinestone ones at the bottom and then the bottle top ones. The way I make mine, I don't like using the epoxy stickers. I like using, it's like high quality grade jeweler's resin, so it kind of sets and you can't see like the glue underneath, so it's lovely. So I made them, we made two sets, and I said I would give them away, so which is why I have my very glamorous assistant. Do you want to, we've got two obviously, we've got bottle top set and the rhinestone set.
Yeah.
Can you use your randomness and pick two winners please?
Certainly. Okay, so I've printed off the comments from the, which video was it?
It was the guy...
How to make bottle top needle minders, of course it was. And, yeah, so... Oh, hang on, wrong thing. If you'd like to hear O Banana, I've got a very popular YouTube channel, so do feel free to stop by.
It's not like plugging your own stuff, is there?
No. YouTube.com/RavensWingFog. Just saying. So, random.org. We've got this set up with the numbery thingy. If you can see that there, but it's all ready to go.
Yep.
Would you mind just double check the last number is 24?
Yep, 24.
Okay.
24 people entered.
Yep. So, generate. And the answer is 10.
Okay.
10. And 10 is?
Simunana?
Simunea.
Simunea.
Simunea. Congratulations, Simunea.
Yep, number 10. Here we go.
Yay.
Well done to you. Oh, you didn't say which one they were going to win.
Well, I've no idea what they're going to win.
Well, I've got two.
Oh, wait.
I've got the bottle top ones and the rhinestone ones.
Well, which ones are they? They're your things.
We'll give her the bottle top ones because that was the first one that's there.
Okay, cool.
Do you want to do it again and then the second one we'll get the rhinestone ones?
Yeah. It's like a well-oiled machine.
Is that right?
Okay, here we go. Generating for the rhinestone ones.
Rhinestone. You sound like, who is the bloke who like enunciates everything? Lloyd Grossman. The rhinestones.
And the second answer is 24.
Ooh, we just had that one.
It's
at the back.
Right at the back.
24. Where's the thing?
Oh, it's there. Yeah, I've not printed it out because of stuff.
24. Can you see that?
Yeah.
Stitching Maiden.
Congratulations to Stitching Maiden. Yes. Well done. So well done to Simone and Stitching Maiden.
Let me get a pen.
Oh, pens. What are we going to do with the pen?
I write that down.
Okay.
So she gets the rhinestone ones.
Yep.
And Tane gets the bottle tops. That's awesome. If you can email me at denkaidesigns@gmail.com. We'll go for that one. Mm-hmm. Just email me your address. And obviously your name, unless you want Stitching Maiden at the top. I don't mind. I don't think Royal Mail will mind. But email me your address and I will post them out to you. Okay.
Okay.
We also have, excuse me, itchy nose.
Itchy nose!
I know, it's really weird because everyone on FlossTube always gets itchy noses when they do videos.
Do they?
I don't know if they get it any other time, but it's just, we just notice it. That it's like the curse of FlossTube videos. It's like itchy nose.
Alcoholics.
It's like attack of the itchy nose. Why alcohol? Why do you get alcoholics from?
Well, because they get like red noses.
I don't. How can you equate a red nose to an itchy nose? The two are completely different.
Oh, because you've got loads of blood going into your nose because it's red.
Yeah.
And that makes it itchy.
No, I don't think so.
Because itchiness is a mental aberration. You're not actually itchy. There's nothing actually on your skin making you itchy.
That's how it felt. Anyway, back to the floss tube goodness.
Oh, of course, sorry. Yes. Have you stitched any crosses lately?
Yes. We've been over the whips.
Yeah.
We've done haul, although there was not a lot of haul, to be honest. I was just saying to them that I might have to buy a few things just purely, obviously, for the video. That's all.
Of course. Yes. Just for the video.
Just for the video.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'll work on that.
Well, there is, you know, an event next month.
There is. There is an event. I already said. There's a birthday.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anyway.
I remember, guys, the more things you buy for her, the less I have to, so. Just saying.
This floss tube, no one on my family watches it.
Oh, no.
Anyway, let's get back to the stitchy goodness. I have another giveaway. This is for 1,000 subs. I managed to hit 1,000 subs, which is awesome. Thank you to all of you guys for all your likes. I don't know why I did a tick. That's sing for a like. And your subscriptions and stuff. It's really awesome. Thank you very much. And I wanted to show my thanks to you. And I have some prizes. So,
ooh.
Glamorous assistant.
Hiya.
If you just reach behind you.
Have you told them about these?
No, I don't think.
I don't know if these come out, but there you go.
The cufflinks.
Yeah. She made them. They're all right.
I made them for Christmas.
Yeah.
So yeah, prizes. I thought we'd have five.
Five?
Prizes.
Oh my word.
I thought this would be awesome. Five prizes. You don't have to sign. I'm not going to say, you know, you sign up for just one or you sign up for two or say which ones you want. I can't be arsed with all the faffing around. So if you sign up, that's it. You're in for all five. And at the end of the day, the free. Who does not like free stuff? So
who doesn't like free stuff?
If you don't like it, give it away to another stitcher. Or if you don't like the prize, then tell me and then I'll give it to someone else.
Waste disposal operatives. They get free stuff all the time and they don't like it.
Anyway, just ignore it. You know, glamorous assistants should be seen and not heard.
Oh, I'm just eye candy now. I've seen the comments. I've read the comments.
You're my sock bitch.
So rude.
Yeah. So there's five prizes. I tried to get them all around the same value. So if you kind of, so one was not distinctly a lot better than the other, and you'd be equally glad to get any of them rather than thinking, oh, I won, but my prize was a bit shit. I should have won the other one. So I've tried to make them all roughly the same, like between £10 and £15. So no, can't really complain. So to enter, you'll need to comment. I'll tell you what you need to comment with afterwards. But once you get a prize, if you do get a prize, obviously that'll make you ineligible for all the subsequent prizes, because there's no point in me giving like five stuff to one person. That's not really that fair. Right, so here we go. First is a little Design Works chart. It's actually a kit. Comes with all the gubbins. That's a U word, that is. And you're doing your eye candy impression.
Well, if I can't talk, I'll do my own model. You know when you get like the two guys just stood in the pants, yeah, looking off into the distance,
yeah,
at the guy who's stolen the rest of the clothes, you know?
Yeah, that's trousers.
Yeah.
Anyway, this is by Design Works, counted cross stitch kit. It's on, I think, 14 count Ada. Comes with all the jars, and there's some lovely little beading. You can see that. And I'm going to throw in one of my little birdcage needle minders. And obviously, with all my needle minders, there's like a little fabric back button. This one's actually a freebie, because normally when you buy a needle minder, I'll give you like a freebie for the month kind of thing. But I just saw it and I thought, oh yes, that goes with the birdcage. So that is one prize. Second prize, or another prize, is this little Oats container. I made this. How adorable is that? Isn't that just like the little cutest thing? Obviously, it's just like material, and it can just kind of squash down and put it in like your little project bag kind of thing, and then you just kind of pop it up, put your little Oats in, and how funky is that material? I love it. I love that. And ho ho ho, what is inside?
It's a needle minder.
It's a needle minder. It's a lovely little beautiful rhinestone dancer. You can see her. There we go. And she comes with, obviously, the fabric back button. So there's that. There's the little Oats thing. And obviously, I want them all to be, like, the same value and stuff. So I will also make a grime guard or a hoop, for like a Q-snap or a hoop. If you tell me what size, obviously, I don't want to make them in all of the sizes. But if you tell me what size hoop or what size Q-snap you use, I will make one in the gorgeous material. And then that will accompany the prize. So that's another prize. The third prize that we have is project bag. I made this, and that's the outside. That is obviously the inside. Lovely material. And
what sort of size is that? So it's bigger than an A4 sheet.
Yeah,
it's a decent sized project bag, isn't it?
Yeah, it's 14 inches wide, 13 inches deep. So it'll fit like 11 by 11 Q-snap in, maybe a plastic bobbins box kind of thing. And obviously it's under the sea themed. There's like shellfish and fish and starfish and lots of fishness. So I'll put in... Where have I? Oh, there we go. I lost it then. there is my little seahorse needle minder, which I love. So that will go with that as well.
Are the fishmongers, do you know why crustaceans have a big section just to themselves?
Why?
Because they're shellfish.
Oh, I should have realised that was where you were going. That was a dad joke.
Thanks.
That was a bad dad joke.
I only do bad dad jokes.
This is true. Mm. Right, there's three. I did say there was five. Price number four is £15 off at my Etsy shop. So So I'll give you a code and you can spend, I think you have to spend something like £17, and I'll give you the code and you get £15 of it off. So, because I can't just do it, the way it works, you can't just do it for that amount. But yeah, so that's £15 there. And I'll also do £15 at any online needlework shop. So whether that's like 123 Stitch, So-and-So, Lakeside Needlecraft, basically any online shop that is for anything sewing or crafting. You know, I'm not going to give you 15 quid online to go buy your shopping. This is crafty goodness.
Yeah.
So
absolutely.
Stitching, quilting, sewing, anything kind of crafty, tell me which online shop it is and I'll get you a £15 gift voucher for them. So they're the five prizes.
That's a lot of prizes.
I think they're pretty awesome prizes, actually.
I'd start watching these videos of yours.
You don't even do crafting or stitching.
I know, but I'll get free stuff. I'm a comment. What do we have to do to win?
Oh, what do we have to do, I hear you ask?
Yeah, if only I knew what to do so I could win these amazing prizes.
If you want to enter, you need to comment below. And to show me that you want to enter and it's not just, you know, a flustered comment, I want you to tell me why you are awesome. So to enter, you need to say, I am awesome because, and then give me a reason why you're awesome. This can be, you know, say awesome, I'm amazing, I'm brilliant, because just something positive, positive affirmation. That's what I want from you. So it could be like, I don't know. I stopped clicking that. That's annoying. I am amazing because. Oh, hang on a second.
Your phone gives you really good reminders.
It does.
Videos.
I'm amazing because. Mike, give me an example. If you were going to enter, what would you say?
I am awesome because I buy myself really nice ice cream.
Okay.
Is that not a good one?
That's kind of weak as positive affirmations go. You can do better than that, Mike.
Okay, let me try another one. Let me have another go at this.
Yes.
I am awesome because I put my wife's socks on for her when she asks.
Yes. Yes.
Well, slippers, to be precise. I don't really have to do socks, but she's got these booty felt.
No, I talked about it already.
Thing. Oh, right, okay. Are you wearing them now?
Yeah.
Yeah, you are. Who put those on for you?
I put them on. I haven't worn them all afternoon, though. I haven't taken them off, so.
Well, I'm on the table all afternoon.
No, you
so
weren't.
Who's been putting them on? Is it Dean?
Yes.
It's Dean.
It is Dean.
I knew it.
Dean's like the.
I'll get you, Dean.
The random mystery man that if ever I was going to have an affair with a bloke called Dean.
Have you told him the story?
No.
Is that a massive detail?
No, this floss tube, we don't mind detours.
Okay, cool, let's do detours.
I was, we were going out together. I think at this point, we've been together a couple of years and I was about 6 months pregnant, wasn't I?
Yeah.
And I texted Mike and he was on a train somewhere, weren't you, for work?
I was on a train to Newcastle, sat with another guy. And I just got this text through, and obviously Sharice knew that I was going to be away all day. And I just got this text through that said, Dean, kiss, kiss, kiss. And I'm sat there and I'm thinking, because, you know, we've been together a couple of years. I know Sharice's family, I know her friends. None of her family called Dean. None of her friends are called Dean. She doesn't work with anyone called Dean. Why hasn't she mentioned this Dean guy to me? You know, not being funny, she's put kisses on the end of the text, so obviously some kind of friend. What's going on? You know, a little bit perturbed, to be honest.
That's a good word.
Perturbed, yes. I was concerned about the situation.
Anyway, he basically replied to my Dean ? With, I can't cope with this right now, I'll talk to you later.
No, I first pretended to be Dean.
Oh, yes, you did.
Yeah.
I
thought, how would Dean respond? This guy that I didn't know existed until now. How would he respond? So I put, yes, babes, because I will normally say
like
that.
The mindset of the Dean from near where we live would be, yes, babes.
Yes, babes. Yeah. So I sent that, and then you sent, like, are you okay?
Yeah, because he would never say yes, babes. He's not a kind of
yes, babes person, yeah. And I'm just like, I'm thinking, look, I'm going to Newcastle for the day. I've got meetings. I'm talking about these management systems. I need to focus on this. You know, I can't be, you know. So I'll just reply quite short. I can't discuss this right now. We will talk when I get home. Full stop. No kisses. You know,
and I was like,
which, as we all know, in text language is sort of, I am so annoyed with you. My vengeance is coming.
And I was just like, what? What's going on there? Anyway, to cut a long story short, at the end of the day, when he manages to get home, I'm like, you know, so what do you think? And he's like, to what? And I'm like, to Dean. And he's just like, oh, yes, the Dean text message. And I'm like, it's a good name, isn't it? And then I think it kind of suddenly clicked that, it, you know, I wasn't actually, you know, knobbing off with this bloke called Dean. It was actually, you know, Dean, question mark. Baby name, Dean, question mark.
Yeah.
Anyway, so he doesn't like the name Dean. We went with Eden. But now whenever we refer to my mystery man or anyone I'm going to have an affair with, if I was, it would be a bloke called Dean who calls me babes.
Yeah.
There we go. Yeah.
Mine's Phil.
He has a workmate called Phil. He goes out with Friday night, so I'm always like, you're going to see your bae.
Yeah. it's quite freaky, because basically any night that I'm out, because I sometimes go to like seminars and things after work, if I'm not home by 8 o'clock, I just get a text saying, are you out with Phil? It's never his tonight. Yeah. She's quite fine, but I'm like, I'm not even out with Phil. I haven't seen him today.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Yes, so, what was I saying? Yes, awesome. So, if you want to enter, excuse the detour, if you want to enter, tell me why you are awesome or amazing. Mm. So, I'm awesome or amazing because I am a kind and caring person. Or because I have an amazing sense of humour, or because I make the best lasagna ever. Mm. That's a fact.
I love you.
So, if you want to enter, tell me why you are awesome. You can win one of the prizes. Obviously, please be over 18 or have permission, because you'll need to give me your address and I'll send you the item, if it's a physical item, or code, voucher code, whatever. So yeah, that is that.
Well, when are you going to be drawn?
I will draw it with my glamorous or possibly not so glamorous assistant.
What do you want me wearing next time? In fact, feel free to stick in the comments. What would you like me to wear for the next draw? You know, I can't guarantee that I'll do it, but you know, let's see what happens. And to be honest, I'm quite relieved, because she was so mad about me wearing a dress and lipstick. So I'm quite relieved with the tux.
Let's go with glamorous.
Yeah.
You do look very nice.
Thank you. So yeah, feel free to stick in the comments what you like me to wear. Within reason, keep it clean, it's family show.
Sure.
Sure.
We will draw probably mid-April when I do the next update kind of thing.
Have you talked about what you're doing in April? Or are you keeping that?
No, then I'm going to Australia. Because we've discussed the...
Yeah.
The baby thing.
Cool. Awesome.
That I'm going to do.
So yeah. So pro tip. If you are thinking about ordering anything from Denkai store, order it before the 20th roughly of April. Because afterwards I'm going to be packing them. So
no, you know, I will. Saying. No, I will leave you with videos on how to do. I'm very specific.
Can we do one of these on how to package a needle minder?
You know I'm fussy and it has to look nice.
I know.
So.
Jiffy bag.
No jiffy bag.
No, it'll be properly. Don't worry.
Anyway, I'll stop rambling now and we'll say goodbye. Thank you for watching, and once again, thank you for all the likes I've got and the subscriptions. Much appreciated. You guys are awesome. I know it. Tell me why you think you are awesome and you will enter into the prize draw for one of the 5 prizes. If you want to leave any other kind of message, that'd be lovely. I like chatting with you guys. If you want to subscribe to me on Instagram, it's denkai_55. And if you like any of my needle minders or you want to check them out, If you go to denkaidesigns.com, it will redirect you to my Etsy page. Do you want to hook in your YouTube video?
Hook.
That's the hoof.
Yeah. If you'd like to see some of my videos, I do various videos. I tend to try and go for funny stuff, gaming stuff, food stuff. So it's one of those three. It's youtube.com/ravenswingfrog. I'll stick a link in the comments below.
Okay.
It's time.
Itchy nose. Fight. Awesome dad jokes. I find lots of things funny. One thing I do particularly find funny is what my dad refers to as toilet humour. Anything to do with like farts or bodily functions I find absolutely hilarious. So, it's a dad joke book, so it's legit dad joke. I'm going to share it. If you don't like it, I apologise now, but I think it's hilarious. Why do farts smell?
I don't know.
So deaf people can enjoy them too.
You can't say that, that's wrong.
Why can't you say
you
that?
Just can't.
Why?
Oh, I don't know.
That's a good dad joke. That's a proper dad
that
joke.
That is.
Do you want another one? Is that acceptable?
It's up to you. Go for another one. Go on.
Really?
It's 1,000 subscriber video. Give them another one.
A bonus joke.
Yeah, a bonus joke. That's what they want.
Okay.
They've sat through 40 minutes for this.
It's longer than that. You just would not shut up, Mr. Chatty.
Sorry.
No, I'm joking. Why didn't you walk?
I'm just standing. You look fantastic.
Oh, do I have to go with another one? Because
no, if you haven't. If you haven't, you haven't. It's okay.
Get me fair. I normally like to prepare them because I like the really good ones.
This is awesome. I love this.
What?
It's the octopusy thing.
I know. I showed so them. Cute. Okay, here's a good one. Why don't you see penguins in Britain?
I don't know.
They're afraid of whales. Do you get it?
I do get it. Bear in mind that there's good portions of the people watching this will go, what? What's that?
Wales. In the United Kingdom, you obviously have England, Scotland and Wales. That's the kind of parts that it's separated into. Obviously, it's a play on words between Wales, as in the place, and Wales, as in the creature under the sea. You see, you made me explain it now, so you kind of spoilt it.
Brilliant, yeah.
So that's your choice of joke.
Yeah.
The funny joke about farting. Or the not-so-funny joke that Mike made me explain about Wales and penguins.
Die, boyo.
Although I did like that one.
It was a good joke.
It was a good joke. They're both good jokes.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's it from me and from him, and I'll see you next month for an update. I do also plan to release another Needleminder guide, and we'll be kind of adapting brooches and things like that, and I'll do that in a week or two. So yeah, there we go. I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Bye.
Bye.
When I stop wobbling, stop wobbling. Right. Mike, you're going to have to cut out all of these mms. They're not very good, are they? Oh. Mike, please edit the coffee. Nobody wants to hear that. At least I don't think so. And this one, excuse me, itchy nose again. This one.
Are you just making bloopers now? No. Is this just bloopers?
No, I have actually really got an itchy nose. Okay. I'll be honest, sorry.
Definitely a blooper now.
That is definitely a bloopy.
A boopy?
Yep.
Definitely some boopies there.
Yeah, you don't want yawning on your fluster. Right, seriousness. Mike, if you could input a new picture, the old picture. A picture.
Okay.
Oh, there's a bit of dirt on it. Balls. That's what you get for doing it in the car.